in the wire mock series, so far I have covered all the theories around it. So this time, this video, I'm just going to demo you the scenarios that we have talked about in the previous videos, right? So this video, I'm going to talk about stubbing. How we can stub the request that we are supposed to call with the outer board, with the third party API, right? So without wasting any time, let's go to the project and see how we can do it, right? So here is the project that I have explained in detail in the previous video. So first thing, to write the test with WireMock, to add the dependency for the WireMock, right? So to add the dependency is extremely easy. So you just have to put a line, this one. So if you want to get this line, you can get it directly from the official website of the WireMock. Come here and go to docs and then getting started. If you are using Maven, so use this dependency. So this tutorial is not dependent on the build tool that you are using. You can use whether Maven, Gradle or Ant as well, right? So for Maven you have to use this, and for Gradle you have to use this. So I'm using Gradle, so I went ahead with this one, right? With the latest version, right? So when I added this dependency and all the dependencies downloaded, so this got downloaded, right? So if I search here my WireMock, so only single dependency is here, this jar, right? So this is how all the needed WireMock dependency for the write to test in WireMock, right? So other dependencies, test implementation for we are using JUnit 5, that is Jupyter API, to write the tests for that. And this is the utility library, Apache Commons library, that gives some methods like overriding equals, hash code and all those things to compare the objects and many more things. And this is this base dependency to write the any API, any REST API, anything in Spring Boot, right? So that is why I have used this. So these all dependencies are needed for this project, right? So coming here, so let me show you what tests I am going to write. So we have this project structure, we have controller. In this video, I am going to use WireMock as a JVM library. So I'll not be writing the end-to-end test cases in this video, but in future video I'm going to cover that as well. So when I have controller, right? So first test I'm going to talk about the update payment. Book ticket will cover it later, right? So when the call will come here, I'll go to call stack here, and this is the ticket booking service for which I am going to write the test. So just reiterate what it is doing. So it is taking a ticket payment request as an input, it is preparing a response, and it is calling a payment processor gateway update payment. Let's see what is here. So it is just posting the update data using this booking ID that is being passed to it. And it is not actually returning. This void dot class means it is not returning anything, right? So if everything goes fine, the payment will be updated into the third party system and we will get the okay response, right? So if there is any exception, we will get that exception, and that exception we are catching here, right? So we are assuming in this case that if the request is reached to the third party, it is success, right? So we are setting success, and if there is any issue in calling the third party API, we are setting rejected, right? And we are returning this one. So just we have to prepare the test for this one, right? So go ahead, write the test for that. This, so this is the test folder that I'm coming here, and this one. So just copy this one and create the general stubbing test, right? So I'm just naming it. So this is the stubbing package that I have given it. So no, we have two packages now, so just remove this one. We are just going to prepare this class to write the test. So we are going to write the ticket booking service, so we need that ticket booking service. And to set up the environment, these are the life cycle call, before each, after each, for writing the test, right? So this is the before each, and similarly write the tear down for after each, right? So this is how it is, and one is for test, right? So I'm just naming it test case one. That's it. So we have this red and just we have to fill up the details, right? So this TBS, so to create the instance of ticket booking service, I need payment processor gateway, right? So just take this one. Inside this setup, I need payment processor gateway, and I'm just going to, no, final is not needed here. Payment processor gateway. Inside this also I need some detail, host and port, from where this host, and so probably host is going to be the local host as we are setting up everything locally, and port I need 8080, right? So this way we will get the payment processor gateway, and using this payment processor gateway I can create the instance of ticket booking service, right? Payment processor gateway, that's it. So this is the skeleton that is ready now. Let's write few more things, then we will introduce payment, we will introduce the WireMock. So let's first see, if WireMock is not there, what is the problem that we are facing, right? So just see that one. So coming, so initiation part, setup part is ready for us, and coming to the test case one, so what we are writing, so what input to write the test that we are writing, writing the update payment gateway, update payment details here. So I need this ticket booking payment request, right? So prepare this one. Ticket booking payment request, and inside this I need booking ID first of all. So just write the booking payment ID, then I need amount to be updated for this booking ID. Suppose I want to update the it as 200, and then I need card details, right? So what are the card details that is there? So card detail, give some number here, local date dot expire, right? So this is the thing. So request is ready now. Now we will call TBS dot update payment details, and we are just passing ticket booking payment request, right? So it will give us some response. Okay, so we got the actual response, right? Now we have to compare the expected and actual. So by passing this one, I need that the booking should be successful. I should get the set success. This success response I should get. So go ahead and assert that. Right, so we are writing this one, response dot get status dot is equal to success, right? So that's it, we are done. So make it more readable a bit, input static method. So we are ready. So if we are not doing any mocking and all those things, so this is the thing, this is the call stack that I need. So when this happens, when ticket booking payment request is passed to update payment details, then I should get the status which is equal to the success, right? So just execute this one. We are seeing that test case is failed, right? So assertion failed error is here. So we are seeing the rejected here to be equal to success, right? So we are expecting success, but it is giving me response. So what should have gone wrong? What would have gone wrong? So we called the update payment. There is some exception in calling this one, and we are getting this rejected response. So I need this call to be successful. So here in update payment, we are not able to pass this base URL, and what is this base URL? This is coming from the ticket whatever you have passed. So localhost and 8080 you have passed, but somehow it is not able to access that one. That is why it gave us the exception, and finally it set the response as rejected, right? So this is rejected. Yes, in the logger itself it is giving that what it is trying to call, right? So but it is not able to call that one, that is why we are getting this exception. Now how we can fix it? Now I need some localhost. If I run any service locally that is running on localhost 8018 and it has the endpoint. It has this update endpoint and which is doing something around that and getting this call passed. Then we can do that. But here we have not that facility to run the actual service. So now I have to rely on the mocking. So now this case WireMock comes into picture, right? So let's include that one. So here it is, and now private WireMock. Now you see we have WireMock, and server and WireMock rule. So these two things are of use for us, WireMock rule and WireMock server. So when if you were writing the test using JUnit 4 version, you can go ahead with WireMock rule. But you know, in JUnit 5 Jupyter versions, JUnit rules are no longer in picture. So with the JUnit 5, I cannot use this WireMock rule, right? I have to use WireMock server. So actually, when you use WireMock rule internally, it is going to start the WireMock server, right? So we are going to directly make use of the WireMock server, not WireMock rule, right? So just hit this one, WireMock server, and set this up here. Just leave the port here and we will configure for that. So configure, there is method WireMock configure for. So what host and what port I need. So I need local host and any port I can give. So here I am expecting port 8080. So that's it. So this is here. So we have configured the WireMock server. Now it's time we start this. So when this is start, so WireMock server here is started, and then we are preparing this payment processor gateway, right? And from here we have fixed the port. So actually I can get it here from the WireMock itself dot port, right? So any port I give here, 8080, 8081, that doesn't matter. We are dynamically getting this port here, right? So WireMock is ready now. So this is running. Now I have to tell it, I have to configure the endpoints here, right? So what request and what response I needed. So for the absolute simplicity, I need that any URL WireMock server is hitting, it should return me the okay response always. It doesn't matter which endpoint I am going to call, but if it is localhost 8080 and any endpoint, it should return me okay. So for that, the first call is stuff for. We are doing a stubbing, so we are calling the stuff for. So stuff for any WireMock.any, I need this, and it is going to match any URL that is there, and then any URL, if any means any request, if whether it is get, post, put, delete, anything, it is there, and it is matching any endpoint, that is update 123, make payment, anything, it is going to return me the response okay. It is going to return me the HTTP status 200, no matter what I pass. So I have given it this one. So no matter what request type and whatever request I pass, it is always going to return me the okay response. And ticket booking service is fine with this one. See, if I come here, ticket booking service, when calling the update payment, it is okay when your third party is returning okay response. So when I execute this now, it should give me the success response now, right? So let's go ahead and execute this. Now WireMock service is into picture, so everything is going to work fine. Span this one. There are lots of logs are coming here. So test case is passing. Now we got the success response. But here see, we are getting a lot of logs here. So if I want to see here, there is many things, right? So you can see all the debug logs are here, right? So if I want to disable it, I have to do one thing. Log back test.x, some things here. So if I put it here standard out and root level I need only info type, right? So if I now if I trigger this one, I will get the only relevant information in the logs, right? So it's a part of the logging, that how you can control the logging, not related to wire mock especially. So there is some problem here, it's not taking this one. No, so there is spelling mistake I think here. Right, now trigger this again, now it should work. Now we are getting the relevant information only, right? Nice. So logger found resources for this one, and this console appender, this it is coming here, right? So info context and ZT server, it is starting the WireMock server here, right? So this WireMock server is started here, and this is here. Now when WireMock server is started, I need to do the cleanup as well. So wiremock.server.stop, right? So this is how we have to do. So this is the first case that I have covered. So any URL and any post, I'm giving it, it is not taking care of that one, but it is returning okay response for anything. So how I can verify it? So if I go here in update payment details, and it is calling this booking payment, if I change this one 1, 2, 3, right? So even if I change this post to get, it is going to work fine, right? So for this to work, I have to do few changes here. Yes, this. So even if I change this and I run our test cases here, it is going to pass them. So it's not okay. I do not want any kind of thing to do like this. So if I do any changes in my business logic, our test case should fail, right? That I am going to fix in the next test case. I just want to say that for extreme simplicity, how we can do it. Yeah, it's passing, right? So, but this is how I do not need it. Update post, right? So let's keep it this way and fix this one in the next test case, right? So let's copy this case that we have and write one more test case where we have some request matching, right? So that request is coming. If it is in this case, we are going to do stubbing, where any specific request that is matched with the stub, only then I'll get the specific response. So this is not the case that I need here, right? So in this case, let's we have written the we have written the test case for the update one. Now coming here in our controller, now let's go and write the test for the book ticket, right? So here, so the previous one I wrote the test case, that the same thing that I needed that was earlier, right? So in this case, pay for booking, I need ticket payment request as earlier. It is extracting the card details, and it is checking that if card detail has fraud alert, it is going to check the it is going to call the fraud check service, right? And after that, if it is not there, if it is not there, it is going in the next line, it is going to do the make payment call directly, right? So if the request has alert fraud check, our service is going to call the fraud check service, right? Endpoint to check if there is any existing fraud or not, and then if fraud is successful, then it is going to the make payment. But if fraud alert is not there, it is directly going to do the payment. So when make payment is coming here, the thing is a bit changed. So it is preparing a payment processor response request here. So actually, this is also a good convention and best practice that the in your API, when you're getting some request from the user, you should directly not pass that to the third party. You extract the detail from there, validate that, and prepare a new request and pass that to the third party. And the same thing I have done here, right? And here I'm calling the post for object and doing the payments here, and here the request is being passed, and this is the base URL, right? So now we are getting the response, this payment processor response, from the third party. Earlier I was not getting any response from that, so I was okay with the okay response. So now go ahead and write this one. So all other stuffs, ticket booking service, WireMock server, payment processor gateway, all are going to same. Just stubbing and this call stack, this payment update, just have to remove this one. pay for booking and what is the request? TBPR, right? So same request and I have to pay and introduce the local variable ticket booking response here, right? So booking response, and this response object should be directly matched with the new ticket booking response, right? And what are the things I need in this one? So the booking ID, that is same, this one it should be 44, and payment ID, that will be that I'll get from the when I'll be calling the service, right? So suppose this payment ID is this one. So this is the payment ID here and this is the response, right? So I need booking response success here. So when I come here, this just make it more readable by importing directly this one. Yes, so this is the ticket booking response. When I call this pay for booking, this response should be equal to this ticket booking response with booking ID, this one that I am passing here. Payment ID I'll get from the payment processor, and success response I should get, right? And how this is going to compare two objects, because it is the 2-1. So if I come here, I have overridden this one, right? So I have to uncomment these calls here. So I have overridden equal hash code and two string here, reflection hash code. This is where I have made use of this Apache Commons library, right? So otherwise there are two different objects, they are going to fail because they will be generating a different hash code. But I have overridden those one to compare the exact booking ID, payment ID and success by overriding those one, right? So now it's time we do the stubbing. Now if I call this one, if I call this one, it is going to fail, right? So because it is stub any URL and it is not returning any body with this one, right? So if I read, let's run this one, see how it is failing. Yeah, it failed, right? So by null pointer exception, it got the null pointer exception at this point, right? So because we didn't get anything in payment processor response here, but we are trying to get out of this something, right? So I just have to stub things in the way that it should return something. How we can do that? Now let's do the stubbing for this one. Stub for, and I need the post request now here, and then URL path. There is this method, URL path equal to, I need the exact matching here. So payments is here, payments endpoint is here, and with not this one but this one. So you have to take care of the this bracket as well. So this is the post call that is expecting this payments, and whatever is returned from there with request body. So I have to pass the request body, the JSON I want to pass here with request body. Here I have to pass what I want to pass, JSON or a string or anything. I want to pass here a string, I want to pass here JSON, right? So, and when I pass a specific JSON here, what it will return? It will return, earlier I was returning this just okay, but in this case I need a specific response that is a JSON format, right? So this is how it is going to work. Just make it more readable by specifying this one, right? So formatted. Now I just have to fill up this detail. So with request body, what is the request body that I am going to get while calling this payment? Just let's go ahead and see that. So clean this one, and this is the payment processor gateway, and this is the payment processor response that I have. And what are the things I have? I have this credit card number, credit card expiry, and this specific amount. So in JSON I need these three things, right? So let's prepare the JSON and then copy paste here. So I'll be having this one. I need this credit card number, specific number, and then credit card expiry. And this is how you can construct the JSON out of you can create the JSON out of your Java object, right? So credit card number I am specifying here, it should be some 14-16 digits, so I am just giving us some dummy number here. And this is the credit card expiry. What is the date for today? 2020. This is the format I need, 1203, right? So this is the date I want, and the amount 100.5. So this is, I believe this is the valid JSON. So let's check that one and copy this one and paste it here. So what is the response I am expecting from this OK one? So if I come down here, so what I am asserting, so this is the ticket booking response. I need booking ID, payment ID, and the success response. So in the same way that I created the JSON out of that one with the request object, we can create the ticket booking response as well. So to create the response, what it is returning, that JSON. So come here, pay for booking, and come here on make payment. I'm expecting this call. So this is the response, payment processor response it is giving me. Come to this one, it has only two things, payment ID and payment response status, right? Coming here again, and payment ID, and then, and this is not there. So this is the payment ID that I need, and payment response status I need. Now pick this one and paste it here. Service request stubbing. So close all others to avoid the confusion, and just paste it here. So this is the payment ID, and this is the payment response success, SUCC, spelling is correct, and this is the payment ID I need. So ticket booking booking ID is the same as the request one, that request that it is making. So booking ID 4x1, and this is the 4x3, so I just have to change this one, it's TBPR, and this. So I think our stubbing part is now ready, right? So there is stubbing for any we are stubbing for post request that is equal to payments, and when it has with this specific request body, that is credit card number this, credit card expiry this, and amount this one, it will return this okay with payment ID and response status. And just check that whether I have this response or whether I have this request or not. So credit card number, I am just passing it card details here. This should be same. So here I have to append this one more to make it equal. And this is the local date, today's date, that is the 3rd of August. And this is the amount, that is 200. So change that one, 200.o, right? So it should exactly match. Now if it is not matching, it will not return this response, it will fail, right? So I think everything is okay now. Let's execute this and see this one. So for each cases, I am going to give a different test class for that. Usually when you are writing in your own environment, you write the different test in the same class, right? So that's fine, but for the simplicity and understanding, I am creating a new class for each. So here it is working now. Started, yeah, it failed because something is wrong here. It is saying that error parsing JSON. So here it should be separated by comma, right? So here is the problem that I did this mistake. So here everything should be separated by comma, right? So just put that. So just putting this one after two things, and the same thing I need in the JSON response as well, right? So this and success. So every member in the JSON should be separated by comma, right? So just trigger this again. So now you see how it is matching. It is trying to parse the JSON that you have given it, and it will match the exact thing, credit card number expiry and all those things. If it matches with the call, it is going to return this one. Yeah, Now we got something different coming here. So here it is giving you the exact thing that is here, right? So if you see the call stack here, request was not matched. So the comparison, the parsing was right now, but the closure, it is giving you that what is the problem here, right? So here is the post payments and you compare the things, credit card number is okay, but the credit card expiry date is incorrect. So I give it 3rd of August, closure system. This detail is with the wire mock. The left side detail that is with closure system, that is there, it is with the wire mock server. And right hand side thing that is here, it is with the request that you are actually passing. So I am passing here 4th of August, right? Here is the problem that I am making with this one. I am just passing local date now, so I cannot pass this in writing the test the current time, because when you it should not depend on the system time, right? So and you can cannot compare that, you have to pass the fixed date, right? So local date dot off, I have to pass the year 2018 and month, what month I need, 8th month I need, month of 8, and the date I need 3rd of August, right? So when you pass the now current system date, so you have to do the same thing as well here. So I am just passing the fixed date, so I have to pass the fixed date here as well, right? So that the things are okay, because when you do the date local date dot now current time, but it is not going to change, so that comparison is going to fail anyway, any day other than that, when the test case is written, you are going to write that. So we do not want that, so I have fixed this one, local date dot off, right? So hopefully it should work, should pass now, so let's see. But anyway, if I get error, that should be different from the previous one. Yeah, there is again failure. Request was not matched, it is saying 3rd of August. Credit. Oh, here is the problem. Here is the main problem here. The thing that we are passing here, we are saying here the request is about the card number, but the stub we are here giving is the credit card number, right? So let's see. If I come here, ticket booking response here, here ticket booking response, not the ticket booking response, but if I come here, so here you can see how we can debug your issues as well, right? So if I come here, credit card, so basically it is failing at now, the date part is okay, but here the member, you see here I have written credit card number, but here it is card number, card expiry. So from where this card number is coming, so actually this is the actual request that we are doing, right? So if I come here, ticket booking and ticket booking payment request, and here is the card details, and if I come here in the card details here, so here we have this number and expiry and card details and number here. Coming one step more back, coming here, make payment. And card, credit card. It is the request actually that we are passing to third party, right? So coming here, and here is the name. Here is just some the mistake that I have done here. So it should not be in this way, right? Actually, this is the credit card number, and this is the credit card number that I am passing. This is the payment processor request, that JSON that it is going to create. So see, this is the just value, this is the credit card number value, credit card expiry date value that is here, but the name of the variable where it is going to hold this one, I know you know this, but just explain this one. Card number, the name of the variable is going to be the card number and card expiry date, right? So the things that I did mistake here, credit card number I took from here. So this is the thing, this is the value that we are passing here, right? So I just have to make this change in our test. service request, and this is the card number, and this is the card expiry, right? So card number and card expiry. So one thing is also clear. So when your request is not matching with the stubbed one, that is with the wire mock, this is how you will get the console log, and how you can see and how you can compare the things, right, and fix it. Trigger this again. So hopefully I not get this error again. If it should pass, even if I get error, that should be different from the previous one. Again error, what's wrong now? So closest is the card expiry date, card number and card expiry. I have to do this, just copy it, mention it. So these are the silly mistake that I'm doing. So trigger it again. So card number is okay now, but expiry date before. So okay, some problem. So what is the now? Request was not matched. Card expiry mount. Oh, again I am doing the mistake, same again. So card expiry date is now fixed. Card expiry date is fixed now, but this is the year difference is now. So 2020, so 3rd of August year. So here I am giving 2020, but here I gave 2020. Now trigger this again. So even a single value mismatch is there, it is going to fail. So how deep matching it is doing, you can see. Yeah, now the test case is passing now. So when I gave the exact request, that is here. So I hope it is clear now. Only then I am going to get this response, payment ID and all those things. So if I do any mistake here on the occasion in the return value, the assertion is going to fail. So I'm not going to introduce that one. You go ahead and try this one, right? So this is how you can do the exact matching, that the URL path equal to something and the request body that you are getting, right? So now moving to the next one. So here in this case, we only had only one API call, right? So this one. So what about in the service, in the method call, we have more than one service call. If I have to do the multiple stubbing, right? So there is only one payments stubbing that I have done. But what if I have to do the stubbing for more than one endpoints in the same request? So multiple stubbing, how we can do it? So let's go ahead and see that, how we can simulate that request. So copy this one, multiple stubbing, paste this one and close all others to avoid the confusion. So all things are going to same. Just coming to this ticket booking payment request that I have here. So this is the payment request that I am passing here, right? So this is the fourth thing, fraud alert I did not pass here, right? So by default it is taking the false value, right? So when I come here in the pay for booking, so it is false, it is not going to call the fraud check. So directly going to the make payment call, so that is fine. So we didn't get this call, right? So in this test case, I want to introduce this fraud check call. So what I can do, so in this TBP ticket booking request, I can set fraud alert true, right? So when now I do this payment request, it is going to do the fraud check as well, right? So if I execute this one, so it is going to fail, I know, right? Just trigger this one and see the failure. Now we will get the request response matching. So the stubbing that I have done is the for the payment, but first request that I am calling is for the fraud check, that is here, right? So let's see how it is failing and how it is going to detect that. So coming here, as in the previous one, we are getting here the closest stub. So request was not matched, right? So closest stub, this is the stub with the wire mock, and this is the thing that I'm expecting, right? So this is the request that I'm making. So this mock, this is the stub that I have to introduce here more, right? So just go here, stub for, now it is the get call, and now we have URL path equal to, what is the URL path? So if I show you this one, URL path is equal to this type, this. So this is the get call, remember, right? This is the get call, and what is the response that I'm expecting with this one? Come here and see ticket booking service, and this is the fraud check, and this is the fraud check response. This is the fraud check card number that I have to pass here, and fraud check response, what it has now, blacklisted. This is the single variable that I have coming here. I do not, now I have this URL path equal to this one with no request body, right? So I'll directly write the will return okay JSON. What is the JSON that I need here? So this is clear from here, blacklisted something is here, ticket booking, and this is the fraud check response. I have to create the JSON corresponding to this one, so I need this blacklisted coming here. And when you create the JSON respective to that, the respective JSON for this for the fraud response that we have is the blacklisted only, and this is the false. When it is true, it is going to give me the rejected, but I need that blacklisted response that I get, that should be false, right? So if I iterate this again, pay for booking, and here is fraud alert. If fraud check response, it is giving me the blacklisted as true, it is directly going to return the response from here, but I need it to pass and do the make payment thing. So that is why I have to make this false. So fraud check response, I have passed it as this is the false that I have given here. So just format it a bit. So will return okay JSON with this request body, right? So, and the first stubbing, the make payments, I have already done, so that should work perfectly fine, and the assertion and all those things are going to same. Just trigger this again. Now I should get this fraud check stubbing as well with the wire mock, and it should match with the request that you are making. Yeah, cool, it's passing now, right? So because we got the both response, so this is how you can do the multiple stubbing in the same unit test case, right? So this is how you can do it. So moving to the next test case, if I come to ticket booking controller here, we have this book ticket update payment, and this batch payment is the last one that is here. And if I come here in the batch payment here, it is taking this list of booking payment request and making the payment out of this one, making the same call that we have this booking for. So actually the call is same for the pay booking, but now it is the batch booking. So now in this case, I'm getting this ticket booking payment request for n number of cards, right? So I cannot determine that it is for this fixed booking ID. There will be variable amount, there will be totally different card details, and fraud alert also. So far that we have written test, right? So general stubbing and this ticket booking request. So our stub is configured in such a way that it is, if the request is for the specific request, specific value, card expiry and amount, then it is going to give me this response, right? So what about, I do not know that what card number it is going to give me. The term is non-determinism, right? So the values that it is going to give me, I do not know how we can stub the things for that one. So let's go ahead and write the test for that. So for this test case, I already have prepared the details. So I hope the things are clear how you can match and pass the request body on response body. So the real time coding was going to take some time, so that is why I prepared. So I'll just explain everything here. So first line, it is doing stuff for post early URL path equal to, it is just expecting that all the requests will go to the single endpoint. That is why I have URL path equal to with request body. Now I am not passing the fixed JSON, but I am just seeing comparing that the JSON that you are passing, if it has card number variable only, it is not going to compare the values that it has. It is just going to see that it if it has card number, if it has card expiry, and if it has amount, then it is going to consider that request as the part of the stub, right? And it is going to return something that what you are saying. In the return case, the return case, I have to do the some fixed things, right? So I cannot vary that one. So I'm just fixing this one, okay JSON, and this payment ID, this is the fixed one. For all the payment request, payment ID cannot be the same. So I'm just removing this one. So this is how you can say that in the JSON that it is returning, I only have payment response status, but it doesn't have payment ID, right? So it is just going to put the null by default that object has, right? So payment response status, for all these requests I need the success response, right? So this is about the payments request. And the second thing, I also have the fraud check request, right? So I have this stuff for, and then get request. And in the get call, if you remember the fraud check in this multiple stubbing part that I have here, the fraud check, it is not taking any request body, but everything is being passed in the part of the URL itself, right? So it is going to be the different for each request. So our URL is being, our endpoint is going to change for each card. That is why I have to change this URL path equal to by URL path matching. Earlier I had only payment, so URL path equal to, right? And then it will return the OK JSON for the blacklisted false. So any card that is being passed should not be blacklisted, right? So any card dot star is going to match the card numbers, anything that you pass here. Now stubbing part is done. Let's prepare the request. I'm preparing the 10 requests, 10 booking payments. It is just the Java code. I hope this is just the Java code and very clear to understand. So it is just generating the booking payment. It is creating the card, credit card details and card numbers. It is taking some random numbers for the card to specific one. And it is giving some local date, some fixed date. And it is preparing the ticket booking payment for each request that for each call that you get here. And for each second card, it is setting the fraud alert as true, so that we can get both the calls, right? So booking payment is this here. So why am I doing this? Because we can see the multiple stubbing and single stubbing both. So for each second request, I'll be doing the two stubbing, right? So the two endpoint call will happen, right? So this is how it is generating the booking payment. When we have this generate booking payment, it is collecting that into a list, right? And then this batch is being passed to the this batch payment. So if I show you this one, this is doing nothing. It is taking this one booking payment, it is just streaming that one. It is mapping that to pay for booking. Pay for booking is the this method, and collecting that one into the list. So we are getting this ticket booking response, right? So when I get this call, I can compare that this hat size, this batch of size. So what is the batch that I have given? So all the calls, all the requests that I have given, that should match with the response, the same response I'm expecting. And then I'm just reiterating through this response stream.forEach, and for each response I'm seeing that this booking status is success or not, right? So that's the simple thing that I have. So the main thing is about this stubbing, that it is not, it doesn't have the fixed value of the request that it is being passed, right? So let's trigger this one. See, hopefully it should pass because everything is clear now. How to debug if any issue, I have explained in the previous cases, right? So in detail, not one error but multiple errors. Yeah, test case is passing now, right? So what we expected and actual thing they are saying. So now moving to the last case, many time it can happen that you have more than one stubbing and there is some concept priority which stub. So if I put the stubbing that is here, the fraud check, if I put the one more stub here, blacklisted, which is returning the blacklisted as true, right? And for one as false. So which one should take priority? This one for the second one that you have. How we can do that? Let's see in the last test case. So this is the last test case that is about priority. So details I already have prepared. I'll just walk you through there. So the first thing is stubbing URL path equal to. I'm just going to the fixed one for this one, right? And this is, you know how you can do this. And stub var, this is for the fraud check request. That is here. So URL path equal to. And here is the thing. Now I have this fraud check call for the same request that is here. And one is returning blacklisted true and one is returning blacklisted false, right? And now I have ticket booking payment request that is making this fraud alert as true. So I have to make the fraud alert call and it is going to do the pay for request, right? So it is asserting these things. So without changing anything, the stubbing and all those things is in this way, just trigger this one. And I'll just create the scenario for the priority and see how it is working. So what is the default priority for the all the stubs that is that it had? So by default, the way you have written in the sequence that you have written this one first and this one second. So whatever is the second, whatever is the last is going to take the precedence over the previous one that is written, right? So here you see the first request that I have written, it is going to return false, and second one, it is going to the blacklisted as true, right? So that is the case that I have got here. Test case one. So what it is returning me? So assertion failed error is there. So expecting this one, booking payment ID null, but actually it is this one, right? So response is status success and all this, all of this one, right? So expecting this one, but it is equal to this one, right? So the actual response that it is trying to compare, so you expect that it should booking response this one, ID this one, success, but it is rejecting the booking payment. Why? Because it has got the blacklisted as true, and when blacklisted is true, what your pay for booking is doing when you get this get card details is it is checking this is fraud alert, and if it is true, it is making this one fraud check call, and is blacklisted is true, it is straight away returning from your booking ID and making the transaction as rejected, right? So let's correct this one, how it is happening, because we have given both the stubs how it took the priority true one. So let's change the sequence here. I just changed the sequence, and if I run this again, it will pass, because now the blacklisted is going to be the false, and it will not make the transaction as rejected. Yeah, this is running now. Market green, so it is passing now. So this is the default behavior, but the sequence should not matter, right? So if I want to enforce our own priority, how we can do that? So that is extremely easy that you can do. So for the default one that is there, so add priority number is there. So if it is true, I do not want this one, and the lowest number takes precedence, right? So the second one, add priority, if I give it one and I give it not 100 but 2. So as many steps that you have, maybe I don't know if any scenario will come, but if it is coming, so you can prioritize the steps which one to take precedence over other. So even if I now change the sequence from here to here, right? So default behavior is whatever is the last is going to take precedence. But when I mentioned this add priority, it is going to work the way I have said it. So if I execute this again, it is going to return this one blacklisted as false. Yeah, it is passing now. So now I have covered almost all the scenario about the request stubbing, the general stubbing, any request, any URL, request non-determinism as well. So if you do not know the what value the exact particular variable is going to hold, how to do that, and request priority also have handled, and multiple stubbing also we have seen, and this specific request stubbing also. So how many scenarios can come that you have to match the request and response? I have covered that, and here I have made use of the JVM, the mock server as a JVM library, right? So there is one few things more that if you remember the theory part, I have explained that anything that is coming to the WireMock server, it is going to remember the interaction that has happened with it or not. So we can cross verify that whether when I'm making this request and I have done this stub for this one and this one and make call for this booking for payment. So while calling this pay for booking, it is actually making this call or not. So that is under the verification. I'm going to cover that one in the next video. So this is it for all. Stubbing with WireMock is complete now. And the next video I'm going to cover the verification. Verification is small video, not a big one. So we are going to make the changes that we have understood in the stubbing with WireMock, right? So we will just add few lines to verify those stuff, and then we will move to the next video. And lastly, if you have still any confusion and doubt, put that in comment section. I'll be happy to help you out, right? So I'll also suggest you that you practice along with this me, with this folder that I have explained. This is going to be the skeleton only. And the second folder, that ticket booking server, it is going to hold the solution that I'm just writing the test cases. I'm just going to push under this one, right? So I hope you found it useful and going to make use of this one. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching and thanks for your time. Take care. Bye bye.